You mentioned after the Diaz fight that you had to now track to go to England and track down Khan as a big fighter. Do you look at it that now that you got it to go? How important is this fight at the Garden?
It's very important. You know, it's fun in general to be able to fight in the Garden in a big fight. You know, it's a great experience, and really words can't describe it. And especially that I got the chance where a lot of people didn't think I would ever be on the stage again after losing the hand. That's even bigger, you know. So it's almost a little bit of a like the article says, my redemption. You know? So in that way, my redemption will continue on May 15th.
How important it is now that you've trained, that you're multidimensional. What's the difference between you and now and like four years ago?
I was always multidimensional. Now I got a trainer who understands that and can work outside the box like I do. You know, he can understand that. He has a kid. He's training right now. He's very athletic and can pull off a lot of things that maybe some fighters can't. So you can work on different things that maybe you can't do. You can't work on with all fighters. Am I different than 4 years ago? Basically, the difference in 4 years ago is I didn't have Sharif training me, number one, but also the experience, stuff like that. But from 2 years ago, there's a major difference, because in 4 years ago, I was actually pretty good. And I went down for 2 years, and then I came back up. So if you compare me from 2 years ago, it's like night and day, you know, because I had in Sharif, I have a guy who thinks outside the box and can work on a lot of things. My old trainer basically didn't know how to think outside the box. And in a lot of ways, I hate to say it, but I was too talented for somebody like him to work with. He just could not understand the talent he was working with. And he managed to pull it off. What he managed to pull off was a great fighter.
Mentally, do you feel on May 15th that the experience will matter in this fight?
I think it can at times, you know. And like I said, sometimes experience is overrated, but, you know, I've been in the fire in a lot of big fights. You know, I've been down once in my career. I've come up short in some fights. I've won some big fights. I've been hit hard. I've been hit soft. Whatever. You know, I've basically been through it. You know, you name it, I've been through it. I've had 30 pro fights, but probably my last 10 or so I've been on a world class level. So, you know, I've been doing this at this level for a while now, and so I've seen it all. You know, and I don't think that can ever hurt you unless you're too old. And at 29 years old, I'm not too old yet.
How do you feel? You were here before with Cotto, with the big house. How would this fight, how different would you feel May 15th?
First of all, again, I'm coming in with more experience and I'm a world champion here. As opposed to with Cotto, I was just looking to be the guy who trying to get his name on the big stage. I hadn't been there before, you know. So that was a big difference right there. But also, we're fighting in a smaller arena in the theater. I fought there in the amateurs, the Golden Glove Finals, the New York Golden Glove Finals are in the theater. I haven't fought there since the New York Golden Glove Finals, back when I was an amateur. So, I fought in the big arena twice, one as a main event, one as an undercard fighter on a big show. So I have not fought in the theater since I was an amateur. So it's going to be a little bit nostalgic.
Your opponent's trainer mentioned that it's bad for boxing to mention like the steroid issue and the allegations. How do you respond to that?
It's only bad if it's unfounded. It's very much founding to what I said.
Okay. Thank you.